Hey Aries, thank you so much for coming to your love reading. Just a couple of things, if you haven't already, please like, share, subscribe, hit the notification bell if you want to receive alerts for when I post my readings. With that being said, let's just hop into this. Top row Aries, that's going to be your twin flame, who you're currently committed to, or some type of long-term commitment. Bottom energy is going to be anybody new that's coming into your life, or if you're dating or single or that type of jazz, or if you're dealing with more than one person. All right, let's hop into it. How does Aries view their current romantic situation with this top energy? How does Aries view their current romantic situation? Okay. Six of Wands. Five of Cups. Page of Pentacles. Five of Pentacles. You know, I'm going to be honest. I feel like there's obviously a lack of communication here, and there's some type of conflict. I feel like right now you and this person may not be seeing one another. Somebody may be very focused on work or income, or be very focused on themselves, I feel like, Aries. Possibly maybe dealing with a Scorpio, a Taurus, or a Leo energy here as well. I feel like with this Mars energy, right? Or let's ignore the signs really quick, but you have the Five of Cups and the Five of Pentacles. So there's obviously a level of conflict that feels very stuck to me. There's a level of stuck energy here, right? And I feel like it's almost paralyzing, because it's paralyzing emotionally as well as like it's manifesting in the physical realm as well. So for some of you guys, you may be struggling financially right now. And it may be because like your heart goes with your finances. It may all kind of wrap together. But I also feel like too, there's something here about not releasing something from the past, you or your person. And what's happening is not releasing that. It's like somebody now is left. I don't know if you've left, Aries, because you're tired of this person not letting go of, this person being selfish. I get an energy of a level of selfishness here. Also, too, there's an amplified energy here where I feel like you've had to take a step back and really look at your partner and ask yourself for a deeper reason. Why is this happening? Why do I feel this way? Why do I feel like I'm being emotionally drowned right now? I don't know why, but I feel like there's a level of emotional suffering where you feel like you can't keep your head above water. And it can be because it's just not enough. Like, I feel like whatever is going on right now, it's just not enough. And I feel like there's a lack of communication and a lack of movement as a unit together, as one. I also feel like, too, there's something from the past that you're being asked to move forward from. But I think that you or your person, it's like you're scared to let it go, or they're scared to let it go because they don't know what comes next. This is something where you or your person have been stuck in a period of time. Either it's with a person that they've refused to let go, or it's a situation that they've not necessarily acknowledged and moved on to the next step. It's almost like for you guys, your person feels better staying stuck in this Page of Pentacles where there's no movement, but at the same point in time, they know where it is, right? They know where to find you, but there's no movement to carry the relationship forward. Give me three more cards here for how Aries feels about their current romantic situation with this person, this top energy. Two of Cups. Page of Cups, Eight of Cups. I think that you guys really do love this person. I think for some of you, you felt like you were being forced to walk away. Like there's some type of choice here that was given, and you or your person had to make a choice. Is it going to be money, or is it going to be love? Is it going to be the past, or is it the future? And I feel like somebody here in your eyes, you feel like they've walked away from love. They've walked away from, or you've walked away, you or your person have walked away from what your heart really wants. Cancer, Venus, right? Venus and Cancer. There's a level of depth here, especially emotionally, that's like no other. You have Cancer, Venus. You have Saturn and Pisces here. It's like there's a lesson here. And I think that you want more because you're not receiving enough. There's a lack of communication. There's a lack of action on this person's on this person's part. I feel like there's a sense of betrayal here. You feel betrayed by this person based on their actions, due to their ego, due to always wanting to win, due to wanting to stay, you know, in this certain persona of I'm right, you're wrong. I'm going to do what I want to do. Like, this person refuses to admit their faults. They refuse to say I'm sorry. So there's silence between the two of you. But I think deep down, you do really do love this person. Your heart is with this person, but I feel like the emotions right now with you or your person are currently bottled up, and I think that somebody's walking away. They're walking away because they had time to assess the situation and realize, like, you're lonely either way. And I think, Aries, for you, it's like, what's the point? Either way I go, I'm screwed. So I feel like for you guys, it's walking away from a situation that's no longer serving you, but I definitely feel like this is a hard situation. And I feel like there's a level of growth coming by you walking away. What about this newer energy for Aries? What's currently, how does Aries feel currently about this newer energy, their current romantic situation with this newer energy? Possibly dealing with a Taurus, moon in Taurus, Scorpio, or Libra. You also have Leo energy as well as Aries Taurus. You know, I'm going to be honest, Aries. You have a lot of people here. A lot of people. I think that you're currently dating, if you want me to be honest. I think that you're going back and forth between whether or not you're ready for a commitment or you want to play the field. I do feel like this time period right now for you, it's a very emotional time period for whatever the reasoning is. Nonetheless, I think that you feel stuck in between making a decision. Do you go with who you love, or do you choose to move forward with somebody who wants something more? But I definitely feel like this is your energy, even though you're over here with the King of Pentacles. I feel like for you, there's an adjustment, right? For those of you guys that are having a new energy coming in, you're having multiple people, but I think that you want to move very slowly, right? You don't want to have a level of conflict, but I don't think that you're ready right now to either let go of this King of Cups, who I feel like is this person up here, or if you're ready to, you know, go to somebody new. It's like, I still feel like for you in this situation, you're still somewhat stuck in the dark. And it can be because you have multiple people to choose from. You may even have three. You have somebody that is financially stable, somebody that you're emotionally connected to, and I think somebody that may even be younger than you. Ooh, all this just almost flew out. Queen of Cups, the Chariot, Two of Wands. You have a decision that you need to make. Cancer, Gemini. Cancer, Aries energy. You're at a crossroads, Aries. You have to make a choice. What direction do you want to move? Do you want to move forward with this person or do you not? Is this something that you're ready for? Have you healed, right? I think nonetheless here, especially with the Two of Wands, it's like the choice is yours, right? It's really up to you with what direction you choose to move. Do you want union? You know, are you trying to have something so that you feel whole? Right? Because right now I feel like you're coming up as this Queen of Cups. It's like you need that emotional fulfillment. But are you willing to move on from, you know, who you're tied to solely in order to have a level of stability? Like, that's coming up strongly. Because I also think for you, if it's too perfect, you feel like it's boring, right? It's like, okay, now what? Now what's going on? And I also feel like too with this person, it's like you guys communicate, but I don't know if you take them seriously. I feel like they present themselves as a King of Pentacles, but for you, you may even see them as a Knight of Pentacles. Like, I don't know about you, bro. Like, I don't know why, Aries, but I feel like this person has said some things where maybe they seem cheap. I don't know why that just came up. And I think you don't like cheap. Like, I don't know. Like, I think that this person has made some weird comments where you've taken a step back and you've thought about it, whether you've, you know, recently gone on a date or something like that. And you're just kind of like, yeah, that doesn't sit well with me. How does this top energy, how do they feel romantically about Aries? How does this top energy feel romantically about Aries? Okay. High Priestess, Justice, King of Swords, and the Six of Cups. This person, honestly, they go back and forth. I feel like this person is honestly weighing the pros and cons when it does come to you. What do I want from them, right? It's like no matter how hard they try to ignore the fact that they have an emotional connection, it's like they're trying to be very logical here, but they can't help it, right? I also feel like too, you know, there's some type of connection here that they can't deny, right? 11, that's Justice, right? There's Libra energy. But it's also two, right? The number two, you have the number two here. This person knows intuitively, secretly, solely that you are their person. This person knows that. This person receives downloads. They receive messages constantly, Aries, when it does come to you. And I do feel like this person is trying to cut you out of their life, possibly for their children, or possibly for some type of past situation or a work situation. They may also feel like right now they have too much on their plate in order to invest in you. But I do feel like there's something here where you and this person, you make each other whole. So I think that they're struggling with this. I feel like they're holding on to you. I feel like as many times as they've told you, I'm done, I'm not doing this, I'm moving away, I want nothing to do with you, I feel like they always come back. They cannot release this connection. There's something here where you and them, it's like you guys are glued to one another. Sun in Scorpio, something definitely can be happening during Scorpio season between you and this person as well. Here's the problem, if you want me to be honest. And I don't know why, but this reading is kind of like all over the place, so I apologize in advance. The problem is, this person secretly knows that you help them get into alignment. They know that you're somebody that helps them move away from conflict into some type of solution. They know that. But the problem is this person would prefer to stay in the dark than they would to go to the light. Because guess what? They know what the dark looks like. A relationship with you, they don't know. They don't know what happens. They don't know what's to come. They also have a very odd way of looking at things. Like for some of you guys, this person may not be into like monogamy, or they may have like never really dealt with like a monogamous relationship where they've gone back and forth between like multiple people. They've kept it very surface level for a period of time, I feel like. Here's the funny thing though. Internally, they know that they love you. Internally, they know that things, sorry, I just bumped the phone. They know that things internally can work out between you and them. They know that. They love you. They have a deep emotional soul connection with you. When I see the High Priestess here, it's like they already know that you're part of their soul family. They know that you and them are supposed to be together. They know that if you and this person work together, something beautiful can happen. And I think that also with you and them, there's a level of healing that happens. There's a level that, of healing that takes place between you and them. It's an unexplained phenomenon. That's what I just heard. I just think that the uncertainty of what's to happen, not knowing, makes them hold back. It's like they're scared of the unknown. They're scared of what's to come. And I also feel like you and this person being together breaks some type of rules. I don't know why, but it's like there's a level of controversy being with you. Whether it's a social norm, whether it goes against a family norm, whether it goes against tradition, there's something here where you and this person, it's a divine love, but at the same point in time, they're not supposed to be with you, or you're not supposed to be with them. But it doesn't matter, because as much as they try to halt it, right, with this King of Swords, that shit doesn't matter, because it still keeps working behind the scenes. Because here's the funny thing. You guys are not the only ones that are trying to connect this relationship, trying to mend this bond. You have ancestors, you have guides, you have certain soul families, soul tribes that are working behind the scenes in order to make this something. I think that this is a situation where they've tried to take it slow. I think that they've tried to shut this down. I think that they've tried to force you to walk away first. And I think that they've pretended this entire time like it's just a fling. But at the end of the day, they know they've had a level of an epiphany here. The star with the high priestess and the lovers and justice, they've had an epiphany that they didn't realize what your life was until you left. What about this newer energy down here? How do they feel romantically about Aries? You know, this newer energy down here, they feel like you're somebody that kind of is like all over the place. It's funny. It's a stop-go situation with this newer energy. They feel like you have secrets, like there's some type of double life that you live. They're curious what you do when you go quiet. They're very curious, and I feel like this person is watching you and they're stalking you. They're paying attention to what you do because they're confused. I don't know why, but it's a lot of Libra energy, right? And you also have the Knight of Wands here, which the Knight of Wands is kind of like the F-boy, F-girl card, right? It's like the card where you're just off doing what you want to do. They view you as somebody that's very passionate. You take a level of action, but then at the same point in time, you're very quiet. This person doesn't know what to do with you. If you want me to keep it real, this person down here does not understand you. They don't. I feel really bad saying this, but they don't have the mental capacity to understand the way that you work, Aries. They just don't. Because they feel like you're somebody that avoids certain things. Like some things don't make sense to them. Like for them, if you're telling them something about yourself, they don't believe it. They're like, that's not true. That's not how people are. They feel like you're lying about certain things, or there are certain things that you're running away from. They feel like you have multiple suitors and that you're dealing with multiple people. And time out, like, let's keep it real. If you're single, you can talk to whoever you want. That's just the reality. And until somebody puts a ring on a finger, or until there is some type of legit commitment, I'm yours, you're mine, like where everybody knows you guys are together and it doesn't have to be expressed. It doesn't need to be plastered on Facebook or Instagram or wherever where you and your boo are like all, you know, that's fake to me, right? It's like people can portray anything that they want on social media, but the real shit is when everybody knows you're together without even having to say it. Maybe you post a picture every now and then, but at the end of the day, you already know what's good. Everybody knows what's good between the both of you. But it's like this person is very nosy, and I don't think that they understand your depth. I don't think that they understand who you are at a soul level. Three more cards here for how they feel romantically about Aries. Queen of Pentacles, Ace of Pentacles, Four of Wands. There you guys are again. I think that they're very attracted to you, if you want me to be honest. I think they're very attracted to you. I think that they feel like, okay, Aries is somebody that's very irreplaceable. Like Aries would be somebody that I could settle down with, that's financially stable, that I could, you know, really invest in. But the problem is, I feel like there's a difference in your energy. This person is coming up as a knight and you're a queen or a, you know, king, whatever, right? So for some reason, I think that this person knows that they're not on your level and that you deserve better. I don't know why, but that's just what I'm getting. I feel like this person knows like you're too good for them. That sounds really bad, but they still want to keep trying with you. Yeah, there's a strong attraction between you and them. What's currently blocking this romantic situation with Aries and this other person, or Aries and this top energy? What's currently blocking the romantic situation with Aries? The World reversed. Secrets, lies, temptation. Some of you guys may be a Pisces Aries cusp, or it can be the fact that somebody, let me just keep going. There's Sag, there's Cancer. It can be the fact that it's the mother of a child that's blocking the connection. It can be the fact that somebody is very emotional right now. But I feel like there's a lot of things that are not being said here with the world. There's a cycle that needs to be completed, Aries, between you and this person in order for this growth or this like, you know, they say three is like the Holy Trinity, right? It's incapable of completing, right? The Holy Trinity, because it's reverse. There's things that need to be expressed here. There's some type of unfinished conversation that you and your person need to have in order for you to move forward. And I think right now somebody is comfortable kind of dancing in the dark, right? Pisces, illusions. It's not a very serious energy to me. It's an energy where, you know, they don't want to talk about anything negative. They just want to move forward to a level of harmony without addressing the issue, without addressing what's really going on between you and them. I also feel like it's distance. Somebody feels more comfortable here creating distance between you and them. It may even be an Aquarius, Aquarius moon, rising, or Venus. You also can have a Cancer or a Gemini that's in the way. Also Leo, Scorpio, Taurus, or Capricorn. That's in the way of the relationship. And I also feel like there's unfinished business here. There's some type of unfinished business that's not come full circle. There's also a level of instability here between you and this person because it's stagnant energy, right? It's like you've done things the same way for a period of time. And I feel like Aries, you're very hopeful that the situation would change the more effort that you put in. But the reality is it doesn't change. And it doesn't change because there's a lesson here. There's something here that's not necessarily been communicated yet. And I feel like it has to do with stability. It has to do with actually forming a union, right? Take a look. We have cups, we have wands, but essentially take this out because this is kind of everybody, but there's no swords and there's no pentacles, right? There's a strong emotional pull. There's a physical one where there's a lot of passion, but there's no stability with inside of your relationship. And I feel like it's because somebody doesn't want to end something from their past. Not only that, but it's like what's blocking it is moving past the instabilities, moving past the lies, moving past the games, moving past this illusion of who somebody is. Like somebody is scared here to let the mask down and really acknowledge who they are, right? Somebody has to have some type of unfound or newfound courage to express their feelings, right? I don't think somebody's done that yet. I also feel like somebody's going through a very hard time right now where they're on a brink of who they are and who they're going to be. That's coming. And I feel like it does have to do with the death of an ego. Right? There's some type of journey here that's not complete. The butterfly journey isn't complete here. However, I think that your person is now fully aware of what's going on, their mistakes, and I feel like they are going to try to maybe make it right, but there is a karmic cycle that has to end nonetheless. What about this newer energy? What about this newer energy? What's blocking Aries in this newer energy? A commitment, work from the past. Possibly a Gemini or a Sag, Scorpio, Capricorn, Aquarius, or a Taurus. Can I be honest? I feel like somebody here want stability, but there's something from the past that's holding them back. There's something that's already been invested in here. There's something that somebody is waiting to come to fruition. But in the meantime, while this is still kind of growing and blooming, they're out here doing the unexpected. They're out here looking for something else. They're out here trying to talk to somebody. I feel like somebody here wants to talk to somebody. They're looking for somebody to talk to. I also feel like somebody's in love with somebody else, if you want me to keep it real, and somebody's over here just trying to, you know, see what's out there, play the field, see what's going on. I don't feel like there's a lot of stability here because I feel like the problem is stability. The problem is investing. And I also feel like somebody is in love with somebody else. I mean, we can call it what it is, but I feel like somebody is pretending, trying to move on, pretending like they're happy or like they're ready for a situation. And I don't feel like it's intentional. I feel like you, I don't know why, but I feel like it's you, Aries. You do want to move on. But the problem is there's something here that's already grown inside you, possibly for somebody else. But in the meantime, it's like they want to be friendly with you. They don't want to lose this connection. They want to be able to open up and have a conversation with you and have you guys move forward and have you guys in a good place where you're moving away from conflict, where you can have an open conversation, because I feel like they miss you. They miss you a lot. Somebody wants to see you. Somebody wants to also let go of, I don't know, like the past. I just keep hearing like, can we just move on? Like this person doesn't want to answer a lot of questions. They just want to move on. And I also feel like for some of you, this person is very focused and fixated on you. They're very possessive when it comes to you. For them, it's almost like they feel like you're pushing their buttons because they're worried that you're going to find somebody else. I don't know why that's coming up. So for them, it's like they're very focused on what you're doing when you're not talking to them. For some of them, I feel like their intentions are to try to throw themselves into work and focus on themselves, right? In order to like not focus on you. But I also think this person has a lot of overthinking going on as well. Like to be honest, I don't feel like this person knows what they want from you romantically. Like their intentions are to be cool, to keep you still hooked, to keep tabs on you, because I'm gonna keep it real, Aries. Like this person keeps tabs on you. Yes, they do. Cross watchers, flip it. Okay, in the comment section, can you put, I'm watching you? Put in the comment section, I'm watching you. Make sure you like the video. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. And I pick a winner in a couple weeks. All right, three more cards. What does this person want from Aries romantically? The Seven of Pentacles, the Page of Wands, and the Eight of Wands. How would this make Aries feel emotionally? Whoa, Six of Cups. Here's my thing though, Aries, if you want me to be honest, with the Nine of Wands. So let's put these up top here. Your person wants to continue to invest, but they don't want to move quickly. That's the problem, right? It's like things, let's just keep going as slow as possible. They want to have a level of intimacy with you. They want to still have that sexual connection with the Mercury, right? There's a lot of Mercury. They want to talk. They want to move. They want something to change, right? Physically, they don't want to be away from you. But at the same point in time, I don't feel like they're ready for a commitment. They're okay with things being the way that they are because it worked for them. It may not work for you, Aries, but it worked for this person and how things were changing with them. Six of Cups, Nine of Wands, for you, it's like the past. You guys would be stuck in the past here. That's what it would be. It's like this person wants to achieve an emotional and physical sense of growth here with you, right? They want that, but at the same point in time, there's no type of material growth. There's no type of growth as far as you and this person in the 3D. Some of you guys, it may not matter, right? But some of you guys, it does. But with the Nine of Wands here and the Six of Cups, it's like, yeah, you're back to where you're in a good place with this person, but the conflict, there was never a solution for what the conflict was. So you know that right now you're still in this transitional period with them where you've not attained what you wanted. You're still connected to them, but you're still at a distance. You're not nearly where you want to be. You're not near completion. And I feel like you're back where a level of plateau is with you and them because it's a very transitional state versus finishing a cycle, right? It's like a pause. Again, it's back to going back to the past to a level of pause. But for some of you guys, you may feel like it's reconciliation and some of you may be okay with that. But I feel like for the majority of you guys, it's not going to be enough. You're tired of being bound and stuck to the same relationship, to the same situation that's not blossoming. It's a fruitless harbor or a harvest, right? You've put everything into this relationship and you've not received, you know, what you've put into it. So you still feel stuck. You're tired. You're drained. But there's still that attachment that's not left yet. What about this new energy? What are their intentions romantically with Aries? Two of Swords, Six of Pentacles, Nine of Cups. Listen, Be careful, Aries, because I feel like sometimes with insecure people, I don't know why I'm telling you this, but I think that sometimes with insecure people, they tend to create games and they tend to do mind games in order to make themselves feel better. Because their intention right now with you is just to kind of keep you as an option. Like, I don't feel like they're ready to make a choice right now, right? Because you have Six of Pentacles, Two of Swords, right? There's options. Nine of Cups, Four of Cups. It's like, I don't feel like they're ready to move forward with you just yet, but they're going to do whatever makes them happy, whatever makes them feel fulfilled. I feel like this person also has multiple options and they're waiting for something here to pan out before they can even move forward with you. I don't know why, but I do. Like, I feel like there's somebody here that they're already dealing with, that they go back and forth with. And I feel like you may have recently met this person, I don't know, on a dating app or on Instagram or something, or maybe you've known this person, but I don't feel like there's a lot of emotions here. I feel like you think the person's cool, whatever, but I don't feel like there's a strong emotional attachment with this energy. What's the best potential outcome here for Aries and this energy, this top energy from now till the end of Jesus? Four of Wands, Six of Wands, Temperance, and the World. I don't know what happens, Aries, but somebody gets their head out of their ass and takes a level of action. Somebody is done talking. There's no talking here, but it's weird because there is communication coming in. Remember how this was our block, right? It's like finally you're getting what you need in order to move on. There's a level of balance here. This was your block, but now it's coming up here. I think you feel good. And there's something here with the completion. Four of Wands. It's beautiful. If you want me to be honest, I feel like whoever you're dealing with is extremely jealous. This person is a very jealous person. So the idea of you with somebody else, or the idea of them finding out that you're dating somebody else, it's making them go crazy. It's like, you know, stealing the precious, right? And I think that this person has had enough. It's like, enough is enough. They feel like whoever you were dealing with is not for you. I think that they've had a lot of late nights where they're up thinking about you, worried about you, worried that you're going to get away if they don't start making certain things in place in order to change, right? They have to eliminate their past in order to move forward with you. Three more cards here. This is a beautiful outcome. I feel like you guys get together. There's a lot of passion, a lot of sex. Hello, can I come in? There's something here that's very beautiful about what's happening. For some of you guys, you're even going to be receiving flowers and an apology. There's balance coming to your relationship. And I feel like you're completing the phase of conflict. And I feel like you're finally manifesting this foundation, this endurance, right? Where you're ready to grow and you're ready to evolve. Look, the Four of Wands goes to the Six of Wands, right? There's a level of growth here. You're pushing forward the growth and you're moving forward into a place where you feel good, right? Where you're in, where you and this person are making the certain alignments, making the certain adjustments in order to overcome whatever conflicts in the past held you back. Three more cards here for the best potential outcome for Aries and this person. Okay, Death, Two of Cups, Ace of Pentacles. Hello. It's an ending, right? The past is ending. There is a huge transformation within you and your person where this is love. There's a new offer. For some of you guys, you may even be getting engaged to or proposed to or having a solid commitment. Somebody is offering you a new beginning, right? The potential here is insane, right? This is a pentacle. This isn't a cup. Listen, I love the Ace of Cups, but miss me with that bullshit. Like, put your money where your mouth is. Not in that sense, but like, show me what I mean to you. You know, take a level of action. Show me what you're going to do to make it right. And I feel like this person does that. I feel like they put on paper or they put in front of you something very significant where they're saying, hey, the potential of you and me, I believe in it too. And I feel like they're taking this and they're shaping the opportunity because there's a level of raw, unstable energy here of love and passion that this person cannot deny. And now it's blossoming into something beautiful. I'm going to be honest, Aries, I was not expecting this. 100%, hands down, like I'm blown. What about this newer energy? What's the best potential outcome between Aries and this new energy? I think you guys just talk to him, cut it off possibly. I think you both know what it is. To be honest, I feel like you and this person were doing the same thing to each other. I feel like Aries, you needed to get over somebody and this person needed to get over somebody and you both came together and you both are like, okay, cool. Like there was a purpose here that was served with this person for the period of time. And again, it's the same cards, right? It's the same cards. It was to create a level of conflict or create some additional tension in order for somebody to make a decision or in order to push somebody to something different. I feel like this down here, it's a wrap. There's too many people or you've just not decided yet with who you want and how you want to be with. Nonetheless, there's something here with this person, Cancer, Aquarius. This person's not been real with you the entire time, or there's been some type of ulterior motive behind this relationship on your end or their end from the very beginning. So that is your reading. I love you, Aries. And until next time, I'll talk to you guys later. Peace.